We are aware that you cannot say because the 17 million Zambians were not put in one corner, then there was no consensus. The constitution does not say for you to change it, you must bring all the people of Zambia. Mr. Speaker, speaking as a lawyer, and I want to be on record, even if they say we are 17 million people, it is not all the 17 million people who must talk on this matter. Because even in elections, it's not everybody who votes. You must be above a certain age. You cannot be at 4 years old. What would be a four-year-old child be talking about a constitution? Let us be real and let us talk about things that affect this country. Mr. Speaker, I'm aware also that the president did mention the fact that there is climate change, and we have seen the effects of climate change, even made reference to electricity. We cannot run away, Mr. Speaker, from the fact that the people of Zambia are crying about load shedding, yet somebody out there is saying there is no climate change. If it's true there is no climate change, we are challenging you to go and fill up Lake Kariba so that the people of Zambia can see. The people of Zambia should see that when you come into power, there will be no load shedding. We are also challenging you, if there is no load shedding, go and stop the floods and then also bring the rains in some parts of the country. We must be sincere and we must be real in the way we deal with these national matters. Mr. Speaker, allow me also to state that I am one of the people who has been privileged to move with the president, either during the day or at night. And in most parts, when you are landing in Lusaka, Mr. Speaker, you can tell that there's darkness everywhere because of load shedding. When you are landing at night, you are able to tell that here there are lights, here it is dark. The president was telling the truth. Even when you are driving from the airport into Mandahill or wherever, the darkness is real. And the president made a clarion call to us. Can we, as this house, begin now to make solutions? The role of opposing government is also to provide solutions. It is not just to talk about government problems or government failures. Because what we know is that we must now, as this house, start planning on how are we going to invest in ZESCO. How is ZESCO going to move into solar energy? We cannot forever depend on hydroelectric power when the rest of the world is moving away from that kind of energy. Today Zambia is suffering because we are not able to plan ahead. So if we started planning today while President Lungu is in State House, trust me, 10 years from now, we will be able to produce even up to 300 megawatts of power. Mr. Speaker, allow me also to state that those who deny that load shedding is because of climatic conditions must stand on the floor of this house and tell the people of Zambia, if it wasn't the rains that caused the droughts, what caused the droughts? Is it the PF government? What caused the drying up of underground water? Some parts of this country, you can go and drill a borehole today, you will not find water because there are no rains. So we must be real, we must be sincere. And Mr. Speaker, as I conclude my debate, today I've gone beyond 5 minutes because I wanted to talk to a lot of issues. Mr. Speaker, as I conclude, I want to state, the chiefs out there, whether in PF strongholds or not, have been crying that they want delimitation. They have stood up and said, we want more constituencies to be created in very vast constituencies. I have in mind Kanchibia constituency, which is the size of Swaziland. I have in mind Kasempa constituency, which is the size of, I can even say the size of Swaziland and Lesotho put together. 22 wards, and some people even say we don't know when we last saw our MP, because even if she was given 1 month to go around, she will not finish. That process of delimitation is under threat. And we want the people opposing Biltene to stand on a mountain and explain to the chiefs to say, we will shoot down Biltene, it won't go through, but we will bring delimitation. I want to know how you are going to change the number of MPs, because our constitution says there shall be 156 members of parliament. So I want you to go and explain to the people of Southern Province, Western, Northwestern, Lusaka, everywhere, who want delimitation. You go and tell them, if the constitution has put a fixed number of MPs in the constitution, and you don't want to change the constitution, how will you increase that number? I can see somebody in front of me looking very worried, but I want to repeat that you should be very careful in the way you shoot down butane, because you might end up shooting yourselves. I am aware, Mr. Speaker, I am aware that in 2016, somebody lost, went to the Concord, didn't know what to do. I was one of the lawyers standing in that court with somebody I'm seeing somewhere here. They left that courtroom worried because the 14 days, they didn't know whether it means 14 days from the day you file, whether we are going to be counting Saturdays and Sunday. Are we going to count 14 days from the day you file, Saturday and Sunday inclusive, or it will be all the days including Saturday and Sunday? That question has not been resolved. And I know that the guy who cried about the 14, sorry, not the guy, Mr. Speaker, withdraw guy and replace the politician who cried about that 14 days. His tears are still fresh. His tears are still fresh. People who thought they would go to State House using a court order are still crying. They have refused. We are saying, let's put 30 days. Because in 30 days, at least, you can call all your witnesses from all over the country, and you can still have time to talk to them. 14 days is not enough. They are refusing. I want to be on record that come 2021, should we go into this election in 2021 with this kind of constitution, the same people who were casualties have remained casualties in ICU. They will remain in ICU because this country's constitution is not clear. Mr. Speaker, let me not just talk about the presidential candidate. Even members of parliament, I am aware that most of the members of parliament here were petitioned. They had election petitions. Their lives were in danger. They were just, I don't know how to describe it. Most MPs were under serious threat because the constitution as it stands right now, if it is not properly refined, it is not clear whether your election petition should be heard and finished within 90 days or it should just be heard. We don't know when the judgment will come out. We are saying it's not everything in butane that is bad. Certain things that are in butane are not even political issues. So those of you who are saying withdraw butane and throw it away must remember that there were people who traveled from all over the country to sit and discuss that matter, and came up with that bill, gave it to the Minister of Justice, and asked the Minister of Justice to present it to this House, which he has done. So all those who are opposed to refining this constitution must stand up and tell the people of Zambia why we should only be paying retirees who retired from 2016 going upwards, leaving the majority of the people you pretend to be talking for, who retired 20 years ago, others are victims of privatization. We have a suspect in mind. We have a suspect in mind. Somebody is accused of having sold companies and become rich. The people who should have gotten their pensions have not been paid. We are saying, why should all those people who suffered privatization not be on government payroll, and then we should only insist on those who retired in 2016? We want to warn you. We want to warn you that if we don't refine that particular clause of the Constitution, the people who speak for you and vote for you will condemn you in eternity. I will tell you the truth. You will never see the light of power. For as long as you remain inconsistent, speaking three languages on one tongue, you will never convince the people of Zambia. The people of Zambia are looking for an opposition political party that is going to stand up and tell them the PF has failed here. As when we come into power, we will do this. As when we come into power, on load shedding, we will do this. On climate change, we will do this. On retirees, we will do this. Long gone are the times when making noise and singing
Honorable
and jumping.
Honorable member for Kabwe Central. Debate a speech.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I want to conclude my debate on the refining of the Constitution by repeating that I saw a meeting somewhere where members of Parliament were telling their electorates that even if Bill 10 doesn't go through, we have a way of doing delimitation. And those people are phoning radio stations where some of us are brave enough to go and appear. And we are telling them that if these people want to come into power in 2021, as they promise us, they must support butane on all those progressive clauses, including delimitation. Those that you have rejected, like deputy ministers, coalition government, let's remove them, put them in the shelves or in the graveyard of constitution-making processes, and then let's proceed, refine this constitution, so that if it's true you will get into power in 2021, as you promise, you will find a good constitution that will be easy for you to interpret as you govern this country. I want also, Mr. Speaker, to say that this speech touched a lot of areas, starting from the livelihood of a common man on the street, to the life of a farmer, to the life of a politician, and to good governance. Those who are saying that it was empty and didn't see anything, I'm encouraging them to start reading. The reading culture of this country is bad. And that is why sometimes people end up shooting themselves, and then you wake up and say, is it true you need a graduate certificate to be MP when the law has already passed? We don't want a repeat. We found a history where MPs don't read and then they agree to everything, or they say no to everything because they've been coerced to do so. We want to pass a constitution together as brothers of one Zambia and one nation. And Mr. Speaker, let me say also, the constitution depends on us in this house, members of the opposition and members of the ruling party. If we do not work together, don't go and campaign, because you're wasting the people's time. I thank you, Mr. Speaker. Yeah.